Welcome back, Heroclix fans. Today we are looking at a swarm team, specifically the Sinister Syndicate. Wow, that was a mouthful. So with the release of EarthX, there's a ton of different combinations we have, so I'm going to pick out the best figures to use, tell you the strategy, which teams you beat and which you probably lose against, and then at the end I want you to leave in the comments a figure that I can build around for next time. I'm going to try and do this weekly with a new series I'm releasing, which is going to be my top 10 figures from each set, and I'm going to sort of alternate them, so it might end up fortnightly, but we'll see how it goes. So the first member of my Sinister Syndicate team is Overdrive. Now some people may have forgot this is still in rotation. There's no question it's one of the best figures, possibly not for just a Sinister team either. In general, it's an incredible figure. It can move your whole team over the board. Basically, it turns into a powered up token, which can then passenger the rest of this team over to your enemy. So it's only 35 points. That was sort of a auto include for me. It does also have empower, so there is that bonus as well. This whole team almost is close up, so the extra damage is quite big. Next up, we've gone for Beetle from EarthX. Couple of reasons. So he has stealth through the Sinister Six United. Because of the amount of people we have on the team as well, he'll have +1 to all his stats. So now you're looking at a 12 attack, 3 damage with perplex, running shot, 18 defense, which is a lot more interesting. Also has energy explosion. But one of the main reasons for having it on a team is leadership, so we can have 4 attacks in a turn, well, 4 characters attacking. But it also says when a friendly character within 6 squares replaces its attack value using the Sinister Syndicate team ability, modify its attack by +1. So this is also a really high base attack which the team ability takes from. So basically anyone around him is going to take his 11 attack. So they go to 11, they get the +1 from his trait, the organizer of the Sinister Syndicate, and then they get +1 because we're going to have 6 figures on our team, and I'll explain how in a second. So all of our attackers will be hitting with 13 attack, which is absolutely insane. I'll jump ahead now. We've got Doc Ock who can flurry as well, so potentially we're hitting 5 times in a turn with 13 attack. We've got the +1 stats and perplexes, so it's probably some quite high damage as well. Once you start comboing some of these abilities with this team, it's just insane what it can put out in a turn. Our next is Mysterio, which is it was one of the LEs. Basically, he can choose to make either 1 or 2 illusions. So that's why he's in this team. If somebody dies, we're going to have to make 2. The start of the game, we're going to make 1. So we've always got that 6, meaning we get +1 stats to all of our characters. He's the most versatile way to do this. There is President Osborn, which does something similar, but he can't choose how many flunkies he puts out, which is why this is slightly better. Again, this is another character with perplex, so that's 2 perplexes so far, on top of the +1, so I would hope most of our characters are hitting for 4 or 5 damage. The illusions also help this character and our next character, Doc Ock, mastermind if necessary. So Doc Ock's probably going to be our big attacker with flurry. Like I say, it'll be 13 attack, 3 damage, +1 because there's 6 characters, so that's 4 damage, and we've got 2 perplexes, so that's potentially 6 damage with 13 attack twice, and that's just one of our characters attacking. You can start to see why this setup puts out so much damage. He's also got cool abilities where he can passenger 2 or he can move up to 4 squares for free. The passenger 1 helps later in the game when Overdrive's possibly taken out. That's one good use for it. I'm just thinking Overdrive's got empower as well, so that's another click of damage. This team just starts to get insane once they're all piled up together. And finally, to fill out the team, we've got Lizard. He's got Indom, which none of the other figures have. He's got blades, so we don't need to pump up that damage. It can go into attack, it can go into defense. And obviously, he's got the same Sinister 6 United, so he gets +1 to all of his stats. He also has 3. If Lizard is on the even click number and has no action tokens, heal in 1 click, which is just a nice ability. That leaves us with 15 points. Now, personally, I like to put the symbiote in there. I think one of your characters has to tie up the enemy team. So when Overdrive dive bombs them, you stick to them and they can't just run away because you need them next to you. You need to be able to attack them. So I'd probably have it on someone like... So it's going to be someone that wants to be up close. So it's going to be Doc Ock or Lizard. I'll leave the last 10 points up to you. You can use any combination of weapons. I think possibly the Steel Energy Blood Axe is pretty good as well. That could go on Lizard. So how does the team play? Basically turn one, what you're going to do is you're going to have Doc Ock free move for four, sidestep onto the symbiote and pick that up. Then you're going to have Overdrive carry the rest of your team to Doc Ock, ready for next turn, and ready to carry everyone into the enemy team. Now you can pop out an illusion token here, just so you've got the plus one stats in case you are attacked. You should have a good bonus, you should have plus five to your roll at the start, because it is a theme team. So you should get map. Ideally you want a lot of blocking, so you can sort of weave in and out when you have to, and you can't be attacked so early on. Now obviously because you're driving up to them, you don't get to attack when you get to them. So this is why you need plasticity to hold them there. And potentially you're going to have to perplex up defenses. You do get plus one, so I would hope most of the characters are sitting on sort of 19 defense. A couple with things like super senses, mastermind, so they're not that appealing to attack. Now one thing I should note is always drop overdrive behind the other characters. Now I know he seems like he's just a taxi, but if they explode overdrive, you're going to struggle to get over to them. So put an illusion, put someone in front that isn't as big a worry if you lose it. Now this team is going to lose characters. Like, don't get me wrong, they're going to get picked off. It's not a bad thing. That's why we've got so many characters in this team. We've got other attackers. We're not relying on one figure. And we've got Mysterio to pump out more illusions. So what kind of team does this do well against, and what kind of team doesn't it do well against? So I think things like Unimind that gets one attack a turn, where this is going to get four or five via leadership and flurry, this is where this sort of team shines. You can pummel Unimind. Like, he may be able to pop one of you, but like I say, you're going to deal a ton more damage than he is every turn. So the one-man armies, this team is absolutely incredible against. Other swarm teams, I think this is good against, because like I've just explained, the stats this team can build, the attack, the damage it puts out is just insane. You can replace Doc Ock Earth X Swarm with the old LE, even turn this into an Alpha Strike team, which is another variation, probably my preferred variation to be honest. So you can fly him over and then he can absolutely pummel them. Obviously with the Sinister Six United, the Earth X one might be better, so that's a decision for you to make. I'm going to give you sort of the team idea, and then I want you guys to sort of think and pick parts and choose what you like about it, and maybe drop in the comments below any variations you think of. Other teams it does well against is Lockjaw, Daredevil, things like that, because you put out a lot of attacks a turn, so you're able to take these kind of figures down, which most teams can't. The only thing I would say is you are giving up points, so you need to be careful, because those teams are based around point denial. Now obviously because this team has to stick together to get the bonuses, the biggest counter to it would be the Hank, I'm not even sure what it's called, pocket tank. You know, the one that you throw at them and it explodes and deals damage to everyone around it. Energy explosion in general hurts this team. Now they are stealthed, but I mean, you can't always be in stealth and there are people that see through it. So there are some ways to get around it. By no means do I think this is like a top team, but I think it's a good enough team to compete with at the like friendly table. But I also think you could take this to a tournament. But that's all for this episode. So in the comments, let me know which figure you'd like to see me build a team around next. But until next time.